I really need to start filming. Where is Sophie? Maybe I should call her. Nothing. Let's try again. Hey Marine, I'm sorry, I couldn't find my phone. And by the way, why do I have so many missed calls from you? Well, I wasn't sure you were going to turn up for the video. Sorry about that, but I'm here now, so let's get started. Hi guys, it's Marine
and Sophie!
Welcome back to my little English page. Today is the last day of hashtag top 10 phrasals. Throughout the series, we had a look at 9 and soon 10 of the most common and useful phrasal verbs in English. Sophie, could you list the verbs we've already had a look at?
Of course! Here they come. Bring up. Deal with. Fill in or fill out. Find out. Go on and carry on. Look up. Pick up. Put off. Turn on.
Fantastic. Now, before we actually start with the lesson, make sure that you subscribe to the channel and also press the bell button. That way, you'll never miss a lesson. So, today we are having a look at the verb turn up. Turn up. And if you paid attention, you will have noticed that I already used the verb in the intro. I said that I wasn't sure Sophie was going to turn up. And by that, I meant that I was worried she wouldn't come.
But can't you also say show up?
Absolutely, it is a synonym.
Yeah, I have heard of show up, but I'm not familiar with turn up.
But okay, now give me the next meaning. Turn up can also mean that something was found, especially by chance, after being lost. So remember, earlier you said that you couldn't find your phone. But you have it now, right?
Yes, right here.
So we could say that your phone finally turned up.
I see. So from your example, could we say that turn up is intransitive and inseparable?
Absolutely. You don't need an object with turn up. And because you don't have an object, you can't separate it. Alright guys, we have reached the end of the lesson, but also the end of the series hashtag top 10 phrasals. Remember, phrasal verbs are very common, especially in spoken English, because they are informal. So don't be scared to use them. Thank you so much for joining us on this phrasal verb journey. If you like the series, please give it a big thumbs up and share. That way we can help and reach even more learners. I have also recently posted a video for those of you out there who are studying without a teacher. When you're studying on your own, it can be quite difficult to know what to study next. In that video, I also explain how you could win a lesson with me. So make sure to watch the video and take your first step towards fluency. Card right here. Thank you so much for watching, guys. That's it for today. And of course, keep on learning. Bye bye.
Marine? She finished the video without me.